have powers, square, and square roots. Powers, what do you mean by powers? In mathematics, you can also call this indices or indices. Are we there?
Yes, sir.
Indices or indices. Powers. First of all, when we talk about powers, we are talking about if you see something like this, 2 raised to power 2. That's what we call it. Or you can say 2 raised to power
2.
2 raised to power what?
2.
2 raised to power 2. 2 raised to power 2. That's the meaning. In that case, what does it mean? It means 2 times 2. Is it clear?
Yes,
which was the value? That was what?
4.
2 times itself. So if you have something like this, 3 square, we also call it what?
Square.
We also call it what?
Square.
This 2 raised to the power 2 is also called what?
2 squared.
You can also put it like this. That is this 2 squared. Squared. Is it clear?
Yes,
2 squared. 3 squared. This is 3 squared. Or 3 raised to the power 2. In that case, the meaning is 3 times what?
3.
3 times itself again, 2 times. So 3 times 3 is equal to what?
9.
So that is power. If we have 4 raised to the power 2, we say it is what? 4 raised to the power
2.
Or 4 squared. Or what?
4 squared.
4 squared. This is 2 squared. This one will be, say, 4 squared. 4 squared. Or 4 raised to power. Raised to power what?
2.
2.
4, yeah? 4 raised to power 2. That's the meaning of this thing here, you are saying. So let's solve it. 4 times 4. And what's the word?
16.
That's the answer. But then if you have something, 1 raised to power 0, is equal to what?
0.
Is it clear?
Yes.
If you have 4 raised to power 0, is equal to what?
0.
It means nothing there. So let's move on. I want to tell you about square root. About what?
Square root.
Square root of numbers. Say square root. Square root. Or root. This is the sign. Square root. When you see something like this, it means square root. When you move from powers, from square to what?
Square root.
For instance, if we say, find the square root of 36. Are we there?
Yes,
from square, what is the square? We are talking about a number that will times itself to give us what?
36.
This one now will now be square 6 times what?
6.
Is it clear?
Yes,
which is equals to root 6 raised to power what?
2.
Can you see?
Yes.
Therefore, because there is a 2 here, with this 2 here, the answer becomes what? Equals to what?
6.
In that same order, if I have something like 9, root 9, find the square root of, are you there?
Yes.
That's how it will be. Find the square root of 9. Then all you do is equals to 9, say okay, 9. What will times itself to give me 9?
It three.
Is what?
3.
Then you now say root 3 times what?
3.
Which is equals to root 3 what?
Square.
2 here, 2 here. This root, square root here is 2. It will go off and answer becomes what?
3.
In the same way, you can do for 25. Let me do here and stop here so far. 25. Square root of 25 will be 5 times what?
5.
You think of a number that will times itself to give you 25. In that case, you will answer, okay, 5 times 5 is equals to root of what? 5 raised to power what?
2.
Is it not so?
Yes,
which
sir.
Is equals to, these two will cancel with this one, what will remain is what?
5.
So you are telling me that in mathematics, you go front, you go what?
Backward.
In this way, when you say square, we need 5 square will be 5 times square. 5 times 5 will give you what?
25.
In the same thing, when you have 25, root of 25, you will now get what?
5.
You go this way, you go that way. That is all about that. Let me give you about cube roots. About what?
Cube
roots. And then we'll end it off there. cubits. When we say cube root, we mean cube roots. So for cube roots, what happens? See what happens. Cube roots. Cube roots means numbers of digits or figures, 3, raised to power 3. This means what? Cube roots. And look at the sign for cube roots. We put 3 here. Is it clear?
Yes,
this
sir.
Is cube root. But when we talk about cube, this is 3 raised to power what?
3,
which is 3 cube. Is it clear?
Yes,
so
sir.
Cube and what? Cube roots. This is cube roots. That is the sign. So when if we say 3 raised to power 3, it means 3 times what?
3
times what?
3.
So let's see the answer. 3 times 3?
9.
9 times 3?
27.
But if you have 27 now, maybe the other way, that is the cube roots. We can move forward and move backward. For instance, you can have something like this. They put 3 here, put 27. Say, find the value. Yes, Anna. Find the cube roots of what?
27.
What do you do? What you do is to do the same thing. Cube root meaning 3 times. You say, okay, 27 will be 3 times 3 times what?
3.
Is it clear? Which is equal to root, cube root of 3 raised to power what?
3.
Because 3 is here, 3 is here, they go off. And the final answer becomes what?
3.
In the same vein, we can talk about 2 raised to power
3.
Which is what?
2 times 2 times 2.
Good. That is 2 raised to power 3. Thank you. I'll call it a cube. In that case now, what do you do? This time, this will give you how many? 2 times 2. 4. 4 times 2.
8.
So what if somebody said, find the cube root of 8? They will put like this, put 3. Are we there?
Yes, sir.
Put 3 here. Put 3 here and put 8. What it means? You think of a number and that number is 2. Is it not so?
Yes, sir.
Put like this. You say 3. You say 2 times 2 times what?
2. Two.
Which is equals to 3. 2 raised to power 3. This one here, then we cancel out. And what will remain?
2.
That is the way. It continues over and over. Let me give you one example, and that's the end. For instance, if we want to apply our, directed numbers, division, multiplications, and what have you, somebody can come and give you questions like this, which they are in our Global Varsity Basic Mathematics workbook. For instance, if you have something like 16. What would times itself to give us 16? 4 times 4 is what?
16.
So we will now say 4 is the answer. So we have 4 plus. What is the cube root of 27? What to multiply into 3 times to give us 27?
3.
It's 3.
3.
So we said 3. All over. What is the square root of
5.
25?
5.
I think it's 5.
Yes.
So 5. See what we're having now. Can you see that?
It's
very interesting. These are the application. We are applying directed number, board mass. In that case now, 4 plus 3 to give us what?
7
over what? 5. It's a fraction. We'll get to fraction later. In this case, this is heavier than this. So we divide. So what will it be? It will be what number? 2 over what?
5.
This is the answer. Under fraction. But if we want to put it on decimal, we can put it on decimal. But for now, we'll stop here.